I'm gonna tell you another story about commitment. So I come to Cleveland my first year. I got this non-drafted kid, non-drafted, free agent kid from Australia. Had played a little bit the year before, had done okay. He's not even guaranteed a spot on the roster. And I come to practice, and every single day, he's picking Kyrie Irving up from baseline to baseline. From the beginning of training camp, guys, trust me, beginning of training camp in the NBA, nobody wants anybody pressing them for. They don't want it. Old, new one, undrafted free agent guy understands and has a commitment to being able to make this team and bring something to it. So he says, to heck with it. I don't care what everybody thinks. I don't even care what Kyrie thinks. I'm going to pick him up 90 feet every single day. I'm not going to let him breathe. Well, that same kid, Matthew Dellavedova, by the way. Okay, this same year, gradually works and works and works and makes his way into the lineup and plays significant minutes. And suddenly, everybody on the team loves him. Loves him. Okay, then you got all these fools out there, okay, who are saying, oh, he's a dirty player. He's a what? He's a dirty player. He's a dirty player because he plays hard? Because he scraps and he claws and dives on the ball and bangs guys coming through screens? Fellas, he just plays harder than anybody. Always. And doesn't stop. Comes to practice every day, before and after practice, works. On his off days, he's coming in, he's getting treatment, he's getting up shots, he's working on some dribbling just to improve his ball handling. He's watching film. He's talking to coaches. His commitment is such that he will take every ounce of energy and every bit of blood that he's got in his body to succeed. Game 3. Last year, we come back from Golden State, it's 1-1. We blow the first one in overtime at the last shot at the end of the game. They beat us. Second game, we come out, we win in Golden State. It's 1-1. Guys, we're missing half the team. The guys are fighting like crazy. They're laying it all out there. Matthew Dellavedova is playing 40 minutes a game. Same guy, undrafted. Unwarranted. Pressing full court from day one at training camp. He's in the NBA Finals, starting, playing 40 minutes. We come home, critical game, game 3. The guy is out there, he's pressing Steph Curry, full court. He's fighting through every screen. He's going after every loose ball. He's diving on the floor like it's the last piece of bread on the table. We win the game. End of the game. Matthew Dellavedova can't get out of his chair. He can't get up. He is so tired and so exhausted, and he has brought himself to the limit, beyond the limit. Guys, he goes to the hospital. He spends the night in the hospital.
24-year-old Dellavedova steered the Cavaliers to a 2-1 lead over Golden State in the NBA playoffs, but was then rushed to hospital with severe cramping.
You know, just cramped up a little bit. Best form of recovery would be just, go to the hospital.
Matty can barely play. But you know what? That's only because he went to the max. And there's not a lot of guys that will do that. There's not a lot of guys.
A rugby background. And if ever you guys ever had an opportunity to ever watch a rugby game and see how tough it is. If you dove on the ground last night, an NBA Finals record 6 times, And last night, I mean, he was on the ground again after the game in the hospital. So
it's really hard to describe what it meant to the city of Cleveland and the people there. The city hadn't won a championship in the three major sports in 52 years, and just the outpouring of love and emotion and for the city and the team was something that I don't know if anyone has seen that before.
That's a young Delly, isn't it?
I think that is. We got the braces on.
Obviously being a country kid with a great story, he deserves everything he's going to get, and he'll probably get a pretty hefty NBA contract to, I imagine.